I think the a bit about the foreign-born nationals getting graduate degrees in the sciences and engineering here, that's been going on basically since the 1980s. There might have been a trickle of it in the 70s, but it happened in large measure in the 80s and 90s. It's still going on. In the early days, we were simply the best opportunities. We had the best science, the best engineering, and their home countries did not. And so it was expected that when they came here, they would stay, and nearly all of them did. I don't have a problem with that. So much of our national character and identity was enriched because of how open our shores were to the creativity of immigrants that come through, you know, for the past century and a half. So that became a boon to our nation intellectually because we were getting the smartest people in the world. But what happens back in their home countries, they begin to develop. The countries recognize what we had recognized for so long, that investments in their infrastructure and in their own science and technology creates opportunity. My great fear was that we would now educate them and then they would go back to their home countries and we would lose the contributions they would have made had they stayed. That's in fact already happening. The third stage in this is they become the professors and the educating class in their home countries, and then they never have to come here at all. By the way, that was the state back before the Manhattan Project. Most of the principal scientists of the Manhattan Project that were here in this country were foreign nationals, all educated in European countries. We did not quite have the physics infrastructure to sustain that kind of intellectual capital to actually engage the Manhattan Project. So we not only tapped foreign nationals, they were all foreign educated. Once we developed that infrastructure here and that intellectual foundation, we became the target for people to become educated from all around the world. I would say that when a nation, not to sound like a broken record here, but when a nation dreams big and has fully funded projects visible to everyone, where a frontier is getting advanced daily, innovations attract smart, clever people. The prospect of innovation attracts them.